Summary judgment is proper only if there is no triable issue of material fact and the moving party is entitled to judgment as a matter of law. Code of Civil Procedure, Section 437C, Subdivision C. A court must strictly construe the moving party's papers and liberally construe those of the opposing party to determine if they raise a triable issue of material fact. On appeal, we review the record de novo, considering all the evidence set forth in the moving and opposition papers, except that to which objections have been made and sustained. The Recreational Use Immunity Statute, codified in Section 846, creates an exception to the general rule that a private landowner owes a duty of reasonable care to any person coming onto the land. Portions of Section 846 relevant to this appeal provide an owner of any estate or any other interest in real property, whether possessory or non-possessory, owes no duty of care to keep the premises safe for entry or use by others for any recreational purpose or to give any warning of hazardous conditions, uses of structures or activities on such premises to persons entering for such purpose, except as provided in this section. A recreational purpose as used in this section includes such activities as fishing, etc. This section does not limit the liability which otherwise exists, A, for willful or malicious failure to guard or warn against a dangerous or suspicious condition or activity, or B, for injury suffered in any case where permission to enter for the above purpose was granted for a consideration, or C, to any persons who are expressly invited rather than merely permitted to come upon the premises by the landowner. Joshua argues he did not enter its property for a recreational purpose. He flew his kite on the Porter property and only entered the Prince property to retrieve the kite after it blew out of his hands. Since retrieving a lost item is not generally considered recreation, Joshua contends the Recreational Use Immunity Statute does not apply, or the recreational nature of his activity was a factual issue precluding summary judgment. Section 846 describes a wide range of recreational activities giving rise to immunity. Indeed, the legislature has amended Section 846 several times since its enactment in 1963 to broaden the range of activities included within the statute's definition of a recreational purpose. Kite flying is indisputably a recreational activity and consistent with Section 846's broad language, we conclude the steps a kite flyer takes to retrieve his wayward kite are included in the statutory definition of recreation. A kite flyer trusts his instrument to the whims and fancies of the wind. That is the joy of the sport. But in doing so, he takes a risk that the wind will blow the kite in an unintended direction or to an undesired location. Given the nature of the activity, we do not agree with Joshua that recreation stops the moment a kite leaves the flyer's control. Still, Joshua insists summary judgment was improper because the existence